At the time of our birth, we were gifted the most powerful tool in the entire universe, our brain. Unfortunately for you and I, this brain of ours didn't come with an instruction manual, so we don't know how to use it. Rather, our brain typically uses us. And I feel in my heart that if we all could just understand the power, if we could all learn to tap into this raw power just a little bit more than we are now, we would lead much more rich and fulfilling lives. So this video is to help get you in the right direction to taking control of your thinking. And not only just that, but also learning to rewire, reprogram your subconscious brain for success. This is a practice, so please be patient with yourself. This is not an overnight pill, overnight success pill type of practice. This is a technique that takes time and patience. So be patient with yourself. I want you to imagine your subconscious brain as an obedient servant willing to do whatever you tell it to do. And not only that, but it interprets everything you tell it as a positive thing. So, here's how it works. If you said to yourself, "I want to jump off of a bridge," your subconscious goes on this massive manhunt. It looks for all of this data, bits of information in the external world to support the idea of you jumping off of a bridge. It starts asking and looking for things like, what's the highest possible bridge I can find? Where is there a bridge located near me? How many other people have jumped off of a bridge? I wonder what it's like to jump off of a bridge. And it goes on and on and on. Your subconscious's only job is to help support the ideas that it is being fed until you fulfill those things, until it materializes in your reality. But where does this subconscious get all these grand ideas? Who's feeding it? It's your conscious brain. Conscious filters down into the subconscious. This is where it gets tricky, so listen up. Your conscious brain, oh my God, your conscious brain is really, it's most times than none, it's at the mercy of your external environment. Most of us are perceptive beings. We're very emotional. So we respond to the world around us. Rather, we react to the world around us. We don't choose what we think. We let our emotions, our mood, our feelings choose how we think for us. So when we go our entire lives at the mercy of our circumstances, we are weak. We have no control over this, and therefore no control of our reality. You always want to be in some form of control of your conscious thinking. This is where the technique comes into play. But before I give you the technique, let me give you an example. When it comes time to people's finances, I can swear this without even having to know for a fact. Most of us spend all of our thought process on the lack of money. They say to themselves, on a subconscious level, "I'm tired of being broke. I'm tired of being poor. I'm tired of not having any money to do the things that I want to do." This is the thoughts. These are the thoughts that are happening on a subconscious level. And so what your subconscious is doing, like I told you in the beginning, is it's looking for more evidence and more data to show you, to fulfill that idea of being broke, of having no money to do things that you want to do, of being poor. That's your subconscious's only job. It's just gonna keep showing you more of that so that it tells your conscious brain that you're not crazy. It's just here to help support you. So you have to manually override your thought process. This is the most difficult thing that I've learned to do. Thinking is done on such a subtle level that we don't even know that we're doing it 24/7. So now I'm asking you to be more aware of what you are thinking, more aware of what you are feeding your subconscious. So taking the finances example again, instead of saying things to yourself like, "I'm tired of being broke, I'm tired of not having money to do the things I want to do," manually stop yourself and replace it with its counterpart. So instead of saying, I'm tired of being broke, say to yourself, I want more wealth. That's it. Don't even go over, this is not an affirmation, this is no special technique. I want you literally just to replace that negative thought. Actually, we won't even call it a negative thought. Broke and wealth are the same thing as far as the subconscious is concerned. It doesn't differentiate what's good or bad. It just takes everything as good. So stop saying those certain keywords like broke and replace them with wealth. Same goes for health. Most of us, we say things like, I'm tired of being sick. I don't want to get sick. Get away from me. I don't want to get your germs. Instead, focus on being in good health, being healthy. Start saying these types of words. I promise you, you will see a dramatic change in the quality of your life the more and more you start to do this. I said it once, I'm gonna say it again. This is a practice. It has taken me years and I'm still not 100% at it. I still have times where I'm subconsciously thinking about the things that are wrong in life or the things I don't want. But more times than not, I've trained myself to stop that thinking and switch it to the positive counterpart, to the other side. And that's what we want to do, recondition ourselves. We've been doing this type of negative thinking for so long that we don't really realize, we don't realize how long we've been doing it, but we've been doing it for so long that it's hard to kind of undo all of that thinking. So this is a minute by minute, second by second practice. I guarantee that if you start this today, you are going to see a massive improvement in the quality of your life. Please take my word for this. This has worked wonders in my life. It has changed my attitude in the world. And because of my attitude change, it's changed how I show up. It changes how I present myself, how I attack new goals, how I deal with certain situations. It's just one of the most remarkable findings that I have personally ever come across. Trust me. I hope this video helps. I will be back next week with another one. Talk to you soon. Peace.